All right, entry six is another, it's one that you're going to really need to not just pay attention to now, but you're going to really have to adapt over, minimally your first 6 months to truly understand where you are in this space of what you're worth. Because you're not going to be what you're worth in the beginning nearly as much value as what you're going to be worth down the road, okay? So when I started, I was doing everything by the hour because I didn't know any different. I mean, I went out and I did jobs and I thought, you know, if I can make $50 an hour, in my mind at that point, I'm thinking, hey, I can get there. You know, I can at least make ends meet at $50 an hour because $50 an hour times 40 hours, a couple $1,000 a week, that times a year, it's $100,000 income. And I thought, yeah, I mean, I can definitely make ends meet with my family when I have a lot of extra money with a big family, but I can at least get to a point where I'm not chasing, you know, the debt monster every month. So every part of the country is going to have a different standard as far as what jobs are worth, okay? If you're in an area of the country that, you know, the economic base is lower, then what jobs are worth are going to be lower. It's just, you know, it just is what it is. But if you get into an area where it's booming economy, you know, you've got a lot of sprawl out from the epicenter of a city that's going out into the suburbs, then you're going to have opportunities to make really, really good money doing jobs for people that are not on the hourly basis. You're going to be able to do jobs that are on a flat fee or on a basis of what is a job worth in a specific part of the country, because they're always going to be worth different numbers, right? And part of this, the educational process of being in this industry is figuring out what those types of jobs are worth. Because if somebody hired me early on to come in and you know, again, these are just things I did, put together a trampoline, put together a playhouse, put together, you know, office furniture for a desk or a, you know, a cabinet or something. Those are all things that you're just looking at a set of directions. They have all the hardware in them and you're putting them together. Very straightforward. And to me, it's shocking, as straightforward as most of this stuff is, that people just don't do it themselves. Now, I think a lot of times it's just there's a fear factor or a, you know, they don't follow directions well, or directions look like a foreign language to them. So they just don't do it. But what that job is worth is hard to walk into somebody and say, well, this job, or, you know, putting this thing together is worth X, because X, as far as your time, when you get better, may be worth three times more than what they paid for the actual thing that you're putting together. So you have to start to realize that there are certain jobs you're just not going to be probably able to do after you kind of graduate certain levels of the industry. And it's happened, and I'll get into some of these things later, but it happens to me now where somebody will want to hire me for something and I won't do it for the price they want because they don't understand that I have a different level or value now with my time. So I try and do all of my jobs at this point on a flat fee or on a per job basis. So when I get the scope of work from the client, I will then take it back and I'll look and go, okay, well, if this is what this is and this and this and this, and I'll add up, say it's four or five line items, I'll figure it out and then I'll come back with a price, right? It's very simple to do that way. But if I feel like somebody has a laundry list of things to do that are very nuanced as far as what could go wrong in them, then I'll ask that person the question, do you have a budget for this particular job? Are you trying to stay under a certain amount of money for the work that needs to be done? Because that tells me immediately whether or not they're even in the ballpark of being able to hire me to do the work. Now, they may say a number that's grossly under what it's worth. They may say a number that's grossly over what it's worth. But I'll be honest with them in either regard. If they're way high, I'll tell them, yeah, it's not going to cost that much. But you're at least, I know that you're willing to spend what it's worth, and I'll do the job for what it is worth. Maybe they say they're willing to spend $2,500, but the job is only worth $1,750. Then I'll do the job for $1,750 if that's what it's worth, right? But if it's a $1,750 job and they're only willing to spend a grand, then I'll tell them that I can't do it for that amount. And if they come back and say, then what's it worth? Then I'll give them an estimate of what it is that I think I can do the work for. And I mean that by an estimate because it's an estimate. Whenever you're given a number, never make it a hard number unless it's a known entity. Meaning, if somebody says, I need a ceiling fan swapped out, That's a pretty known entity. You ask them, you know, can you send me a picture of the one that you're buying or a link to the one that you bought so that I can go in and research it? Because there's going to be different nuances to each one. You know, are the you know, the newer ones, do they snap in, you know, the blades? Do I have to, you know, how many screws am I going to have to put together? Is the mount going to hold the, you know, the thing that it's going in on? Is there already a fan there? Once you understand all that, then it's a pretty standard industry where it's going to be somewhere between $125 and $175 to hang that fan, right? Okay, that's pretty easy. So you can tell them, boom. But if you're going to go in and do something where they go, hey, I've got lights, but I want canned lights. Okay, and I've got one light right now, but I want four canned lights. You don't know the issues that you're going to run into when you get into the ceiling. You don't know how long it's going to take for you to run all the wiring to make those lights work. So you give them an approximation of what it's going to be, knowing that you're probably going to either be higher or lower than that, and potentially almost always you're going to be a little bit higher than that because you don't know what else you're going to run into. But you don't want it to be so far off that at the end you come back and it's $500 or $1,000 more than what you told them, because then they're going to think that they got ripped, and you don't want them to feel like they've been taken advantage of. So you, and another thing that goes into this is that when you get into a job, if it truly is a lot more work than what you anticipated, you need to immediately tell the client, this is where I'm at, because we just ran into this issue, and you need to be upfront with them so that they can either pull a plug and pay you for what you've done already, or they can say, proceed. I'm willing to pay the extra money because I know that there's more complexity to this job than what we originally had talked about. Most people are going to be okay with it. Some people aren't. But being open and honest with them is always the better way to go than to wait till the end and then surprise them, because most of the time it's not going to end well for you. Okay? So as you're going through this process of understanding how to give and be okay with an estimate, you're also going to have to understand how to sometimes go back and find what are these things worth, right? Because I don't, even today, as long as I've been doing this, there are still certain jobs I get that I'm not quite certain what is the industry standard for this particular thing. And because I do such a vast line of work, I'm not just in plumbing or woodworking or electrical or, you know, painting or whatever. I do all of it. You know, I build decks, I build additions on homes, I do all that stuff. But there's certain things that go into here where you're like, oh man, I haven't thought about that one yet. And so you have to figure that out. Well, there are a couple different reputable sites. One is called HomeWise. So it's HomeWise. And that is one where you can go in and they have different calculators with a different, you can put in a zip code, and then you can figure out an approximation of what that job is going to be worth. And it's got multiple different things that you can break down so you can actually see what is the labor going to be? How much will the cost of goods potentially be? What is my allotment for the tools that I have and the rentals that I may need? How much is going to cost for me to do the cleanup and the debris removal? All those things matter in looking at a job. And so you have to be able to see those types of nuanced line items when you're coming up with an estimate that, you know, that is somewhat flexible. Home Advisor as well, they have, if you were to type in, what does it cost to paint a wall per square foot, and then type in Home Advisor, there'll be something that comes up in a search that will show you it's, you know, $7 to $15 a square foot, or, you know, whatever it is. I mean, I'm just giving you ballparks, but I'm saying there are different ways to come up with very reputable numbers that are going to, you know, pass the sniff test, let's call it, with a potential client. And when you give them these estimates and they go, whoa, wait a second, I didn't know it was going to cost that much, I will then take screenshots of those things and I'll send them to them so that they can see, I'm just not coming up with this. There are different standards that are out there that allow people to know what something is worth. So I think that's a great overview of how to understand your worth and make sure that you're getting it. Always understand and take this away. The more that you're in this, the more that you grow, the more that your worth is, the more expedient you become, right, with what you're doing, the better off you are. Because if your efficiency rating goes up, that means you can do more jobs, or it's less taxation on your body. And so the more you can stay mentally right and physically right, the better product you're going to produce for the client you're working for then and the next client you're going to work for potentially the next day. All of this matters in this industry. Take it to heart and keep making yourself better. Next video is going to we're going to talk about is how are you going to get from job to job? What type of vehicle are you going to be driving?